a lot of stuff on campus, so that's at the bank teller level, had to make the transition. You've got new data and new ways to deal with much more data that are now functional because of the power of computing, hardware and software. This leads to new ways of knowing, knowing that can unite both sides of our brain in an integrated, culturally sophisticated manner, not known since early pre-literate cultures. In other words, not only are we going to rationally know mathematics, we're going to dance and sing about it, and make color combinations that reflect things. I think it's very important to check out the work of Rod Eglish at in New York. He's got a book out called African Fractals. In other words, when we did our Blackman's hair site, in linking to his site, where he's got a whole chapter on Blackman's hair, where he talks about how it is based on fractal mathematical design. And so that the task is to get people who know how to do hair to understand they're working with fractals. In other words, to take what's on your head and make it knowledge, you put it in your head. And that says a lot about what it means to be democratic in our scholarship, because often what happens is, in our search to know, we distance ourselves from the community and the culture that we operate in. And in fact, something as obscure as a fractal is as familiar as somebody braiding somebody's hair. And so it's that connection that we have to constantly make. My project is about the cyber resurrection of Malcolm X. When I say cyber resurrection, I'm talking about, I don't know how many people here are Trekkies, I'm talking about the holodeck. That's the direction we're going. We're talking about, ultimately, with holograms, and lasers, we're going to be able to represent the past in a way that we can sit down across the table and have a conversation with almost anybody in history. I mean, in other words, all you have to do is go to Walt Disneyland and you'll see what the future's going to be. At least that's what we think and hope. I mean, I just love the idea that our students will be sitting there with Sojourner Truth and Malcolm and whoever and having a conversation. In other words, interactive dynamic databases that really connect us to what we're talking about, both for teaching and also for imagining new questions.